I want to assure each one of you here that to reach the desired goal of full unity, the Catholic Church does not intend to impose any conditions except that of the shared profession of faith. Further, I would add that we are ready to seek together, in light of scriptural teaching and the experience of the first millennium, the ways in which we can guarantee the needed unity of the Church in the present circumstances. The one thing that the Catholic Church desires, and that I seek as Bishop of Rome, the Church which presides in charity, is communion with the Orthodox Churches. Speaking at the end of a Divine Liturgy celebrated by Bartholomew I, the Ecumenical Patriarch of Constantinople, Pope Francis expressed in strong words his desire to continue along the path to unity between the Catholic Church and the Orthodox Churches. On the feast of St. Andrew the Apostle, the first called, the brother of St. Peter and founder of the Church of Constantinople, the Pope recited the Our Father in Latin during the Divine Liturgy. In his speech, he recalled the Second Vatican Council's decree on ecumenism, Unitatis Redintegratio, promulgated exactly 50 years ago. In that document, the Council Fathers noted that the Orthodox Churches have true sacraments, above all the Eucharist and Holy Orders. They also acknowledged the importance of preserving and sustaining the rich patrimony of the Eastern Churches, not only with regard to liturgical and spiritual traditions, but also with regard to the canonical discipline that regulates the life of those churches. Pope Francis emphasized that this encounter between persons, the exchange of the sign of peace, is an essential dimension of the path toward full unity, and that this encounter precedes and accompanies the theological dialogue. Speaking ahead of the Pope, Ecumenical Patriarch Bartholomew I spoke of Francis as a herald of love, of peace, and of reconciliation, capable of offering to the Orthodox brothers and sisters the hope that the churches will continue to draw closer together, recognizing in the body of the Church a primacy of love, of honor, and of service in the framework of synodality. The Patriarch went on to note that, sadly, unity among Christians is realized in some regions through martyrdom. At the conclusion of the liturgy, Francis and Bartholomew stood together on the balcony of the Patriarchal Palace to offer their blessing. Following the blessing, the two leaders proceeded to the throne room for the signing of a joint declaration. In the text of the declaration, they emphasized that there exists also an ecumenism of suffering, but also that the situation of Christians and those who suffer in the Middle East requires not only prayer, but also an appropriate response on the part of the international community. The declaration also noted the continued significance of the theological dialogue promoted by the Mixed International Commission and stressed the importance of promoting a constructive dialogue with Islam.